Join 7 CFAC Calgary.
With another edition of the Stampede Wrestling Show. Have we got action for you? Half a dozen matches. Some of the key ones, Jason the Terrible against Strangler Steve DeSalvo. For the middleweight championship, the Great Gamma facing Chris Benoit. Boy, that should be an absolute dandy. And Owen Hart has drawn a mystery opponent. In addition to that, I noticed Diana Smith hanging around the premises. I think she's got a mission. She's going to talk to a young man named Johnny Smith. She's not too proud of him. We'll have all of that and more in just a moment. Biff Wellington against Johnny Smith. One fall, 15-minute time limit. Dean Hart looking it over carefully. There's one way out. Look out now. Something's got to give. Clothesline. And it was Wellington receiving as Smith was giving.
That's one of the most deadly maneuvers in all of professional wrestling, that flying clothesline. Two men going together at lightning speed. And suddenly, it's as if the old head bone is going to get separated from the neck bone. Look at the weasel now. The weasel was attacked last week by Ed Whalen. Ed, you should have finished him off.
He irritates me. Irritates me. Why does he get my dander up? He's so obnoxious. Anyway, watch this. Pull him down. Very nicely done. Yeah, you invariably get your ears boxed with that maneuver. There's the takedown small package to Just.
Wellington looking very good, trying to put away Johnny Smith. Another maneuver. He's got him. Two. Just a two count. Wellington trying every maneuver. Here we are again. Look at this. Smith turned it around momentarily. We have just passed the 10-minute mark. Wellington acquitting himself very well, but don't count out Johnny Smith.
Well, even as you speak, Smith regains control of the proceedings. Johnny Smith, Manchester, England. Biff Wellington, Lloydminster, Alberta. And that's Smith up top. Got the knee on the throat, the hand on the rope. Now, there you go. We saw interfering. And that could come at a critical time, but right now it's not critical, except for Wellington, who's down on the deck for one. That's all.
Johnny Smith is a quality wrestler, but of course he was allegedly fed up with the Hart Mafia. He says that people like Bruce Hart, Brian Pillman, Chris Benoit, they don't deserve to carry his wrestling togs. Johnny Smith says he was not given a fair opportunity to challenge for either the mid-heavyweight or North American heavyweight title. That is why he switched. He also says the reason is money. We'll see if it pays off. Look at that move by Johnny Smith. A great move by Wellington. Both men flying around the ring.
What an entry by Smith. Loses his balance, runs into an arm drag right away. Gets knocked outside again. Whoa, boy, was there a malfunction at the junction there. He missed his target entirely. Did Biff Wellington lands out on the carpet, which has concrete underneath, and he is in trouble.
Referee Dean Hart was checking him out. He is now commencing the count. He is counting Biff Wellington out outside the ring. Wellington obviously feeling the severity of that long drop onto the concrete. He is getting to his feet. It might not be quick enough, but it is. He's getting back in the ring with some rather not nice assistance from Johnny Smith. Look at this maneuver. Oh, Smith wound up turning it around.
Shut up, Weasel!
2 minutes remaining. 2 minutes.
Well, we're at the 13-minute mark. It is slated for 15 as to regulation time. Wellington jammed to the corner. It's a turnaround. Smith gets clotheslined. But Wellington not looking very strong. Now, Smith. I mentioned that statement about Wellington not looking strong because he was grimacing in pain when he was just above us. He's been shaken up, but look at him carry on. Gets his man wrapped up. Crowd says, let's give it a shot. One more time, one more time. Boy, Wellington got messed up, did he not?
1 minute.
Just 1 minute left. Johnny Smith outside yelling at him. Drags him in.
45 seconds.
45 seconds remaining. That's it. And there's your winner. Your winner, Johnny Smith. Not exactly a popular victory. Right now, we're going to switch you to the ring. Jim Davies talking with Steve DeSalvo.
Okay, Strangler Steve DeSalvo, and it's the match that many people have been crying for. You and Jason the Terrible, a very formidable opponent for you.
I've been crying for it. Jason's been cowarding. Of course, how can he cower? Because he doesn't have a mind. And I do have the ultimate mind, the one that can control Jason's little simpleton mind. Jason, you're going to be in for a beating. But how can I translate that to Jason? Maybe you could. You're on the same level. You're in the same crustacean level that Jason is. Jason, you are very formidable because you do not feel pain. You cannot feel this 27-inch arm wrapped around your throat, decapitating you. And maybe he could still probably think better, couldn't he, without his head? It doesn't make any difference to him. But Jason, you're very tough. You're almost invincible. But invincibility is just a word. This is strictly action right here, Jason. Take a look. Jason, I want you to take a look at these. And what is that going to tell you? Defeat. And it's not going to be a 1-2-3 count, Jason. It's going to be very pretty for me and the people of the United States. It's going to be total destruction.
Okay. Okay. A very confident man, Strangler Steve DeSalvo.
John Coble out of Lethbridge. And there's a very important show coming up there Sunday night. Would you like to tell our audience about it?
On Sunday, Ed, the Sports and Leisure Show in Lethbridge ends, and Stampede Wrestling is going to be the climax of the whole show. We've got a big card, and it's one of the biggest cards we've ever had in Lethbridge for Stampede Wrestling. And we're asking all the fans in Lethbridge and Southern Alberta to mark Sunday the 20th as the day to come out and see Stampede Wrestling at the Exhibition Pavilion.
Exhibition Pavilion. You've got lots of good seats available there, I know.
Yes, there are lots of good seats left, Ed, and also with the Sport and Leisure Show, they've worked out a discount deal on the tickets. They'd have to check at the door to see exactly how that works.
Okay, John, nice to have you on the show. Good luck. That's Sunday night, this Sunday, in Lethbridge.
For sure, there are a lot more important things than a wrestling match, and that's the health and welfare of my friend and partner, Bruce Hart. Fortunately, the staff at Holy Cross did a great job. He's come along fine. I expect to see him make a miraculous recovery and be back in the ring. I got some other good news, Jim. Our bad jams, so I get the camera to pan down here on these. We're getting millions and millions of requests for these.
They are pretty spiffy. Hey,
you wearing these bad jams down on Electric Avenue, Jim?
There'd be no stopping me.
But anyway, Friday, Good Friday's coming up. We're going to make a bad Friday. We're going to launch these nationally and try to supply the demand that's out there. We're looking forward to doing that.
Okay. Now, how soon will it be before Bruce gets back and you can defend that International Tag Team Championship?
Well, there's no exact timetable, Jim. I'm just hoping a man of Bruce's stature, he's got the intestinal fortitude. I know he'll be back before anybody else would expect him to be so, and he'll be in top form.
That's great. Thanks very much, Brian Pillman.
And Mukka Singh and Jerry Warhol against Sonny Warcloud and Mr. Hito. One fall, 20 minutes. We've gone cannonading past the five-minute mark. £380 of beef went flying through the air there. Warcloud making the tag. It's Hito against Mukka Singh. Little old jam session in the corner.
And that'll give Mr. Hito an Excedrin headache, number 472. Mukka Singh and Jerry Morrow both drilling their heads into the temples of Mr. Hito, who is in pain. There was Mukka Singh trying to pound away at the head of Mr. Hito, and all he got is a sore hand for his efforts, but in comes Jerry Morrow.
Well, this is concrete against concrete, I do believe. Both of them noted for their headbutts.
Always a lot of matches happening when you're right here live and in color. Right now it's Mukka Singh wailing away at Mr. Hito, who should be making a tag pretty darn quick, or he will be facing the possibility of being pinned.
You know, I look at Mukka Singh, the 380-pounder. And I am amazed, there's a one count, just one. I am amazed at how he can carry on 30, 40 minutes in a fight. He's got amazing durability for a man his size. You would think he would run out of gas. Now it sounds like I'm praising Mukka Singh, which is rather unusual for me, but I think he's kind of remarkable at that weight.
It is remarkable. Very remarkable. It'd be like you or I carrying around a 1953 DeSoto in the ring with all that extra weight he's got on his rather portly form. I'll tell you, it is amazing that the man just doesn't donate his body to, I would say, a candle factory with all the extra tallow he's got on hand.
The bear hug. Hito's gonna have to jam his way out of here somehow. Yes, sir, like him or not, that Singh can really go the distance. The tag was made. I don't think the referee saw it. No, he didn't. Dean Hart is waving Warcloud out of there. He did not see the tag. Oh, my.
Well, you can't really blame Dean Hart for that. He was trying to keep Jerry Morrow out. Here's a sleeper maneuver. Mr. Hito trying to put the sleeper on. In comes Mukka Singh. Lays the big forearm across the neck of Mr. Ito and breaks that little maneuver up. There's the tag, and now Mukund Singh is in legally.
Cover. One. That's off. This is one fall. There's a 20-minute time limit. Can he make the tag? Now he makes the tag again. Again, the referee does not see it. Oh, my. Look at both of them are going after this man. Big splash, and that should do it.
Two, three, it is all over. Your winners, after that dastardly maneuver, are the team of Mukund Singh and Champagne Jerry Morrow. And now let's go to ringside, where Ed will chat with the winners.
Well, you caught a referee there, not seeing what was going on.
First time in my life, I'm going to come out and openly admit you're right. That referee didn't see nothing. I don't even know if he's in the right building, but we're not worried about it. The Champagne Man and I had a long winning streak of tag matches, and you can see it's still going, Waylon. It's still going. Now, you know what? I want to set my sights on Omar. Where is Omar? All these months, all these weeks, everything I keep waiting, I keep challenging him, Waylon. How many times has a guy, a man of my caliber, got to challenge a little boy like him before he finally shows up? Well, I got a surprise for you tonight, Omar. When the big mystery man, the two-time champion, the big strong man starts pounding on you, Omar, you're going to say, oh, my God, I hope there's enough left for Mukund. Well, get ready, Omar, because that mystery man's coming for you. And I'll tell you what, with Apu and a Champagne Man, there'll be a lot of eyes on the ring. So you get ready, Omar, because you're going to get drug around like the little punk you really are.
So?
Yes, Ed Whelan, I know Owen Hart still Mukund his belt. He's afraid to defend it to Makar because he knows he was losing it. Owen, bring the belt if you don't want to defend Makar. Just give it to him if you don't want to get hurt.
All right, all right.
Well, Jonathan Holliday, you're a relative rookie in the pro wrestling wars, but already I know you've made quite an impact with the fans.
Yes, I have, and I would like to personally thank all the fans from Toronto, Montreal, to Vancouver, to Edmonton, to Saskatoon for sending all the cards and letters that I've been receiving. And another thing I would like to get on to is the fact that, Mr. Davies, I hear that you're getting married. And I'd like to congratulate you personally, although I do think you're making a little bit of a mistake. I think you should come out to Electric Avenue with Dr. Holliday and let me show you why I've got the market cornered on the woman's saturation factor. And let me teach you a little bit more about life. But if you're going to be happy when you get married, that's fine. I need to make a public apology also to Coconut Joe's and Singapore Sam's about the skirmish I caused last week when I pulled up in my stretch limousine. It happens no matter where I go, whether I'm in Los Angeles, New York, Miami, it always happens. And you can tell by the great people up here, over here, and behind me that these people are behind me 100%. And I would personally like to thank them all for just letting Dr. Holliday, the man that can procure, recure, and satisfy any woman's ailments in 15 minutes or less.
Okay, Dr. Jonathan Holliday, soon to be appearing at Hugh Hefner's Playboy Mansion.
That's right.
I am delighted to see you walk into the ring, Rick. You weren't even limping. Things okay?
Well, things are okay for me, but not for Mr. Brown. You know, it's not going to be, it's no longer months or even weeks. It's down to days. We're just waiting for the commission doctor in Edmonton to give me the okay to get in the ring. As far as you know, I'd be in the ring by now at this point. And, you know, as the fact of the matter is, he has a history of trying to take wrestlers out like this. My only fault, you could say, was naivete. But fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. It's not going to happen. It's not going to happen again. And every time and minute, there's not a minute of the day that goes by that I don't think of you, Mr. Brown, and what you did to me in that big 275-pound frame coming down on this leg after it had originally been intentionally twisted, being thrown over the top rope, which should have been a disqualification.
Right.
Rest assured, it's not going to happen again. And there's going to be dues to pay, and I'm afraid that, Mr. Brown, you wrote a check that you just will not be able to cash. Thank you, Mr. Brown.
Thank you very much, Brett, and we'll be right back. Usual happenstance. Owen Hart, the North American heavyweight champion, 225 pounds out of Calgary. Jim Davies is in the ring to make the introductions.
In the corner to my left.
And I don't know who this guy is.
Heavyweight champion.
And Owen Hart, well, he's a legend here.
Your referee, Jürgen Herman, one fall.
A real ovation, as per usual, for Owen Hart. This is one fall with a 30-minute time limit.
I don't know what the hell Muffin sings up to.
He said Owen Hart talking to the crowd, and he now is maintaining that this man in the corner was not a North American heavyweight champion.
I've never seen you before in the ring. I don't know who you are, but I'll tell you what. I mean,
Owen Hart says,
I would take on anyone.
He says he'll fight him anyhow.
Okay.
Well, I have known all the North American heavyweight champions, and this guy is not one of them. Here we go. Jürgen Herman, the referee. Oh, here comes Bucka Singh. Oh, he bangs him on top of the head. He's got knuckle dusters. And the other guy leaves.
Muck and Singh said he was picking an opponent for Owen Hart who would wear him down, a mystery opponent. This guy is supposed to have been a North American champ. Owen Hart says, no way. No way has that man ever been North American heavyweight champ. This was a setup all the way. Muck and Singh bushwhacking Owen Hart.
Oh, my, did he fly. Cover, one, two. I have a little trouble understanding why the referee is letting this go on. It was not scheduled to be Muck and Singh.
Well, referee Jürgen Herman, bewildered, as usual, he's not sure what should be going on, but he's in the ring. He figures that Muckin Singh has a legitimate shot at Owen Hart. He's just letting the two of them go. One is the North American heavyweight champion, Owen Hart. One is the number one challenger. Of course, this is a non-title affair, but
it's not even supposed to be a fight.
Muckin Singh does not belong in there, as you say. But there he is, and there's nothing the referee is doing about it. Almost a three count. Owen Hart just got his feet up on the ropes. I don't know why Muckin is in there, but that's the way it is.
Owen trying to get his motor started. He's been unable to do anything, of course, since being attacked with the knuckle dusters. The victim of a clothesline. This is supposed to be a 30-minute time limit. One fall, 30 minutes. Here's the bear hug being applied by Muckin Singh now.
380 pounds of pressure from the big man from Saginaw, Michigan. He's pouring it on to Owen Hart. The crowd chanting Owen, Owen, Owen. They love this young man, this popular young wrestler. Look at him. Oh, he tried to pick up Muckin Singh, and he wound up with the toilet bowl right on top of him. Muckin Singh thought he had the pin. Very, very close.
Well, that's a lot of weight to handle. He's got the dusters again. Referee hasn't seen it. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, he's fibbing to the referee. He told him he didn't have knuckle dust. Tusk, tusk.
Well, he threw Owen over. Here comes Owen coming back over the ropes. Oh, big flying drop kick. The knuckle dusters go flying. Owen Hart picks him up, and he's going outside after Mukken Singh. Whoa, this is crazy.
He's just hammering away at this guy. Just hammer, hammer, hammer. They're going to count both of them out.
Both men are being counted out outside the ring. Owen Hart pounding away at Mukken Singh. He's using those big knuckle dusters. And now the referee, Jürgen Hermann, is wiping the whole thing out. It'll go into the books as no contest. And now let's join it at ringside.
What were you doing in there?
You know something?
It wasn't your fight.
Listen to these people. Shut up saying that, Owen. Shut up saying that. Shut up saying that stuff. He thinks he's so intelligent. He brags about having all the brains. I'll tell you what, he signed a contract to wrestle a big, tough, two-time North American champion. Who can that describe, Whalen? Who does that describe, Whalen? That's me. You even know
yeah,
that.
But you put
you
another fighter in the corner. That makes
doesn't
no sense.
Matter. If he's dumb enough to chase somebody else when he's supposed to be wrestling me, that's not my problem. Now, Omar, why don't you show up and put a belt on the line? Again, I had to chase you all over after I got in the ring with you and squared off man to man.
He wants you.
He wants me? How come he doesn't wrestle me then? I chased him around this building so far I could be on a track team somewhere.
Yeah.
Omar, get ready. You stay in the ring. I'm tired of chasing you, Omar. I'm tired of having to beg you. Get in the ring with me man to man. Forget about everything else. Because it's time, Omar. Now it's time. Right. It's a war. It's me and you and the only one. Shut up. Can you listen to these
Owen.
People?
They love,
they love who? They love who? They don't love nobody. They don't love nobody, Will. You
Owen.
Shut up too, Will. They
Owen.
Don't love nobody.
Owen. 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 All right, here's Jim Davies.
Well, Owen Hart, once more you run into the skullduggery of Mukken Singh. He says he wants you. He says you're running from him. Can you believe this guy?
Jimbo, I'm not fooled by Mukken Singh. I've been around a long time now. I'm aware of what kind of tactics he tries to pull. Tonight, he had some guy under a mask claiming he was a two-time North American champ, that he was going to come out here and beat me. Well, I'll tell you something, Mukken Singh. I'm a little bit smarter than that. I'm not as dumb as you are, Mukken. You came in the ring, you jumped me from behind, you used knuckle dusters, you tried everything you could to beat me, and you still couldn't do it, Mukken Singh. And I said it a long time ago, I'm not scared of you. You've been my biggest rival in wrestling, and I'd love nothing better than to get rid of you once and for all. You've been flapping your mouth off, saying what you're going to do when you get me in the ring. Every time we get in the ring, you got to jump me from behind. You can't fight me fair face to face. You always got to cheat, Mukken. But I'll tell you something. This long road, this big road that we've been crossing, it's going to come to an end one day. You and I, we're going to square off in this ring, and we're going to end this feud that we've been building up for years. I'll tell you, Mukken Singh, I beat you for this North American belt, and I know you would love nothing better than to come in this ring and beat me for this belt, Mukken Singh. You come in, take your best shot, Mukken Singh. I'll fight for my life for this belt. It means more to me than anything that I've ever worked for in my life. So, Mukken Singh, you be the first man. Come on in here. Take your best shot. Go for it. Give it all you got, because I'm going to give it all I got. And when I end that match, I'm hoping and I'm knowing that I'm going to walk out of that ring with this North American belt still around my waist.
North American heavyweight champ Owen Hart. And we'll be right back with more wrestling action.
This Banvil herbicide is going to give me tough-to-kill broadleaf weed control, and all for only $3 an acre. Isn't that great?
Hard to kill weeds for only $3 an acre? How do you figure?
I'll tank mix the Banvil with 2,4-D, and it'll kill pigweed, cow cockle, wild buckwheat, and even Canada thistle.
Sounds like you're in a TV commercial to me.
Arlene, can we have some more coffee, please?
Banvil. Tough-to-kill weed control for only $3 an acre.
The power the source of improved performance that sets Formula Shell apart. And only Shell's got it. Get the power of Formula Shell for a difference you may actually feel.
Shell! The boom is on!
Whoa, a giant monster muffin chased me in my sleep last night. I kept fighting at the muffin as we ran along. And when I woke up, my pillow was gone.
There's no better time to satisfy a Tim Horton Tim Muffin craving. Because right now, for a limited time, when you buy three, the fourth one's free.
You owe yourself the best tasting in the land.
Now buy three, get one free.
The Makita line of cordless tools is now on special. Check selection and price at the House of Tools. Two locations, 12th Avenue Southeast and 33rd Street Northeast.
Tonight at 7.
Where did these humans come from? How did they evolve? The African ape are under arrest. Take it.
Based on the famous Scopes monkey trial, Inherit the Wind, starring Kirk Douglas, tonight on 2 and 7.
The new Eagle Premier has just been voted best car built in Canada. And we've just made it better. Not only are we offering Chrysler's 7-115 warranty, we now guarantee that Premier's retained value will at least equal the best of any comparable Ford, Buick, Olds, or Chrysler. So now you get one of the best values when you buy, one of the best warranties when you own, and an unprecedented guaranteed value when you trade. The ultimate guarantee.
I do have flight 139 leaving in 20 minutes, but only in first class.
I'll take it. Okay, they're calling my flight. I'll be there. Much.
No, it just started.
Where is she?
The second potted plant from the left.
Coming through when you're needed most. Membership has its privileges.
Wrangler Steve DeSalvo and Jason the Terrible. The bear hug. He's just pouring on the pressure. Jason is hanging on. DeSalvo applying the pressure. Finally, a headbutt gets him out of trouble, and that was the logical move. When you're wearing that mask that he has. But I haven't seen Jason take such a pounding in a long time.
Well, Jason is a notorious slow starter, but you cannot afford to have this kind of a start against a man of the caliber of Steve DeSalvo. DeSalvo is just cranking away at the back of Jason, but Jason right now seems to be rallying somewhat. He had his arm extended, the crowd cheering him on.
10 minutes, John, 10 minutes.
We're now at the 10-minute mark. Jason the Terrible against Strangler Steve DeSalvo. One fall, 45-minute time limit. Jason under pressure with a bear hug. Doesn't seem to know what to do about it. And this DeSalvo's really going to work on the man.
He certainly is. It's surprising to see DeSalvo dominating Jason. And there is a bit of a comeback by Jason. He gave him a big knee, big shoulder block. Jason making a spirited comeback. Oh, he's tossed out of the ring over the second rope by DeSalvo, and DeSalvo's going out after him.
Well, they're on the far side. Well, you expected that slam to be forthcoming, did you not? Crowd is kind of hushed because they can't believe how DeSalvo's dominating at the moment.
Strangler Steve DeSalvo, the big 290-pounder out of Los Angeles. And he wants to ram Jason's head or his body into that ring post. You can see him starting to line it up. He's giving some punches into the neck area. Here he goes for that ring post. Oh, Jason turned him around. He put DeSalvo into that post.
Jason up into the ring. They're going to get out. He was counted out. Just a minute. What are they doing? What's the decision? They're ringing the bell.
DeSalvo was counted out outside the ring.
Look at it. Oh, he drops him right smack on the table. Some of the guys coming out of the dressing room and trying to straighten things out here.
Well, Gil DeFosse has been pushed around. Randy Thatcher has been thrown right out of the ring. DeSalvo is the loser of the bout. He was counted out outside, but he is not stopping.
The action continuing in that ring, and he continues to pound Jason. Now he's throwing him over the top and off that table. My merciful heavens. He roughed up the referee. Did you see him? I just saw him out of the corner of my eye. He roughed up the referee, did DeSalvo. A black card. A black card. And that means suspension.
Strangler Steve DeSalvo has been suspended. Referee Jürgen Hermann. But look at this. Still, Jason is being pounded into that ringside table by DeSalvo. It is unbelievable.
What a mess. What a mess. The lovely Diana Smith, wife of Davey Boy Smith. And you and Davey must be a little upset with Johnny.
Yeah, we're not trying to, I'm not out here to chastise or criticize Johnny for being corrupted by the Karachi Vice after everything they've done to Owen and to Davey, but I just want Johnny to know that the door is still open, that his mother and father are deeply hurt by what he's done, and they love him, and Davey loves Johnny. They're heartbroken about what he's done, and the door is still open for him to... Davey's mom and dad are even coming over, and they're trying to appeal to Johnny. They just want Johnny to come back. The door is still open for you, John.
Johnny, doesn't family mean anything to you?
Just listen. You've got it all wrong. You don't know the whole story. It's just you've got a biased opinion because you don't know any better. It's just a mistake. It's just a mistake. Exactly how you've seen it on TV. There's more to it than meets the eye. I'm sorry.
After everything that Davey and Owen have been through with the Karachi Vice, I don't understand why you turned your back on them, John.
I keep telling you, there's more to it than meets the eye. I'm sorry. Davey Boy Smith, that's all I ever keep hearing. When I was growing up as a little kid, it was always Davey this, Davey that. Now I'm over here, it's Owen, it's Bruce, it's Pillman. Even Wayne Hart, the referee. I'm human too, I've got feelings. What about me? I need respect. I'm as good as them. I can beat Davey Boy. I can beat anybody. I just need the chance to prove it. Davey Boy is a bulldog. You just got him like a trained pup on a dog. He just says, sits up and begs and says yes to you. He should never have married you. He should never have married you. He should have stayed in England. He's a traitor. I'm not a traitor. He should have stayed in England and married Jennifer. He was going with Jennifer before he met you. She was a nicer girl than you. He should stay with his wife.
A better family than my family and my brother Owen.
Your family, I can't think of anybody worse. All the family, even Stu, they get on my nerves, they make me sick. It's always Davey Boy, it's always the family, it's never me. What about me, Ed? What about me? I was the Commonwealth champion. I was the next champion. What about me? You made me sick, you get me up to here. For God's sake, can't you see it my way? Can't you see it my way? For God's sake, can't you see it my way? Can't you see it? For God's sake!
Why are you insulting her?
I'm not insulting her! I just want anybody to see it my way. The horse made me sick!
Well, I don't understand. Here's Owen.
Ed, listen here, Johnny. You got something bad to say about my family and my friends. You say it to my face, Johnny Smith. You're a traitor, Johnny Smith. That's what you are. You become a traitor, Johnny Smith.
Just listen to me, Omar. I'm talking to her. I'm not talking to you. You don't know one word of what I've said to her. I'm talking about my brother. It's got nothing to do with you. So keep your goddamn nose out of my business.
Oh, it's got nothing to do with me, eh? Well, that's my sister. And when you talk about my...
Well, I don't know. They're having a long look at each other. And I don't know. Owen Hart is not enamored of the fact... Well, enamored of the fact that his sister was insulted by Johnny Smith. And listen to this crowd. And here comes Bucca Singh. Oh, he was bushwhacked. And Johnny Smith goes after him. Can you believe this? Disgusting. Disgusting. They're going to pound away at this guy. And he was bushwhacked once again. And here comes a chair. Sweet guy, this Johnny Smith. Sweet. Oh, my heavens. That's horrible. That's disgusting. You're some hero, Smith. Some hero.
In a perfect world, your brakes would be fixed by a specialist.
Are you the brake specialist?
Yeah.
But the world isn't perfect.
Yeah, that's me.
That's why there's Midas, where trained brake specialists make your brakes their priority.
Here's your Midas brake guarantee. Perfect. As close as you can get.
Midas, top guns for brakes.
Guess who's in town a little early this year? With his cream eggs from Cadbury. They've got a shell of thick Cadbury's milk chocolate. And a sweet creamy yellow yolk surrounded by delicious white filling. They're here now. And now make you feel as if spring is just around the corner. But when Easter's gone, so are Cadbury's cream eggs.
Big card Friday night at the Pavilion. Owen Hart facing Mukka Singh in the main event. And in the other half of what you could call a double main, it's the Great Gamma against Chris Benoit, a return match for the mid-heavyweight title. The Cuban Assassin is back in the territory. And WrestleMania 4 comes to the Stampede Corral. Vacant world heavyweight title is on the line. WrestleMania 4 at the Corral, March 27th.
Fagnan's Furnace Service, the ultimate in clean. Fagnan's truck-mounted power vacuum system. No job too big or small. Designed to power clean home and industrial furnace systems. The ultimate in service. Bonded, licensed technicians that cover everything from preventative maintenance to 24-hour emergency service. Fagnan's keeps your air clean with the introduction of the Neutron Electrostatic Air Cleaner. Totally energy efficient and half the cost of electric air cleaners. Neutron eliminates up to 100% of irritants by replacing your present furnace filter. Fagnan's Furnace Service. We've got the answer.
For the Commonwealth mid-heavyweight title, challenger Chris Benoit, champion Great Gamma, just about at the 10-minute mark, and Gamma is the one who's down on the deck in the corner. Boy, he's taking a pounding. Benoit looking very good in the last 5 minutes. After Gamma dominated in the early going, off those ropes now. Oh, he got him right on the kisser going by.
Well, it's amazing how Chris Benoit has gotten his second wind. He's trying to turn him over, and he is pouring on the pressure. Gamma looking very, very, very much in trouble, but he managed to break out of that with a handful of trunks. I'll tell you what, Benoit wants this belt.
Abdominal stretch. Look out. Oh, just a minute. Just a minute. Is he calling the match? No, just a minute. Just a minute. Just a minute. Wayne Hart is explaining that he jumped over.
Wayne Hart is saying, and he is the senior official, he's saying, let the match continue. He said Gamma went over the ropes of his own volition. Well,
here's Wayne right here at ringside.
Senior official, it's a manual override. He jumped over there on his own power. Chris never did anything to assist him over the rope. It's just a cheap way to try and get the belt on a disqualification. I'm not going to let it happen. Match continues.
Okay, the match continues. Thank you, Wayne Hart. And justifiably so. Herman was about to call the whole thing. He got conned. Whoa! Whoa!
2 3/4. Gamma couldn't come any closer than that to retaining his title. Benoit has to find a second wind, however, and he's not going to get it like that. He just had his neck pounded down onto that top rope, and the weasel is outside the ring cheering on Gamma. But the crowd is cheering on Benoit. Maybe they can motivate him. Maybe he can come up with something extra.
Well, Benoit's good at that. That's something extra. And this is a chance that he probably won't get again for months and months if he fails to win the bout, because Gamma will make sure it won't happen again. Oh, caught him right on the throat, side of the jaw, turns him over, makes the cover. It's a one, it's a two, and he got the shoulder up. Gamma very cocky now. He figures he's got it all wrapped up.
Well, he better not think that too soon, because Chris Benoit, as we've said before, is a very gutsy competitor. He can take a lot of punishment and still somehow find that inner reserve and come back. I would not be surprised to see the momentum shift once again in Benoit's favor if he can shake off the cobwebs. Here's the Cobra.
He's got that Cobra hold on him now. That could put him away. Benoit pounds his way out. The Cobra again. Again, it's Gamma with the Cobra. Can he hang on? Benoit in real difficulty now. Most of Gamma's opponents go down with that Cobra. Benoit's on his way down right now. He's got to get out of it. Can he do it, Jim? There's one.
It is anybody's guess. That is two. If his arm drops a third time, that's it. He keeps his arm up. Keep in mind, the Cobra, probably the most deadly sleeper hold, cutting off the supply of blood to the brain. They both go out. They both go out. Now Gamma laying the boots onto Benoit outside the ring on the concrete. He goes back in the ring, and Benoit badly shaken up, lying outside on the concrete.
Crowd exhorting Chris Benoit to make the comeback. His long-awaited title chance. Just a minute. He's got the sleeper. He's got the sleeper. No. Low blow gets him out. What's this? What's this? Johnny Smith? He hit the wrong man. He hit the wrong man. Cross body block. 1, 2, 3. It's over. It's over.
We have a new Commonwealth mid-heavyweight champion, Chris Benoit.
The crowd is going clean wild. Chris Benoit is the new champion. And listen to this crowd. They have just gone wild. And an elated Chris Benoit is being absolutely mobbed in mid-ring. Do you believe that?
How sweet it is!
Hey, you got that right. There he is, the new champion, Chris Benoit, and the celebration goes on.
It's a scene of celebration. Everybody is going wild. Our new Commonwealth mid-heavyweight champion, Chris Benoit.
Jim, this is the greatest moment
of my life. All the blood, sweat, and tears I've gone through to get this belt. And now it pays off, Gamma Singh. And I'll meet you anytime and anywhere to defend this. Because I am the true junior mid-heavyweight champion.
The champion, Chris Benoit. The crowd goes wild. Look at the celebration.
This place has been pandemonium.
It's right before your eyes, Ed Woolen. You saw it. He threw some sort
of powdery acid.
Chris Benoit threw some sort of powdery acid. Tried to cripple me, eliminate me from professional wrestling. Ed Woolen, that kid couldn't beat me. Fair and square. I beat him in the middle of the ring.
He threw me
over the top. He was disqualified. Wayne Hart has no business sticking his nose in this ring.
He came out and had the match. I'm still the Commonwealth Mid-Heavyweight Champion. One more thing, I'm not as stupid as you may think I am,
because there was a clause in that contract. He has to put that title on the line against me next week. He'll be around my waist. Chris Benoit, you better sleep with that title for the rest of the week.
All right. Rather enraged. Great guy. Well, it has been wild and woolly, has it not? I hope you've enjoyed the action. Look forward to seeing you next week at the same time, but in the meantime, in between time.